This was a rigged, disgraceful trial. The real verdict is going to be November 5th by the people.
Moving on now to that other historic news happening today. Former President Donald Trump, you heard his reaction right there. After being found guilty early this afternoon on all 34 felony counts of falsifying business records to hide hush money payments to adult film star Stormy Daniels, he could serve up to 4 years in prison, but we won't know more until his sentencing, which is scheduled for July 11th. In the meantime, a lot of questions remain in this unprecedented case. So former U.S. Attorney for Minnesota Tom Heffelfinger has been following the case from the beginning. He joins us now live for more perspective on the verdict, where we go from here. Thanks for joining us, Tom.
Thank you, Kent. Happy to be here.
Now, after following the arguments in court through this process, were you surprised by the verdict today?
I was not surprised by the guilty verdict. I thought the prosecution had met its burden. I was extremely surprised, however, by the very quick, what I considered a quick verdict.
Yeah, you mentioned that, especially with those 34 counts. And of course, I think a lot of people wonder what happens from here. So can you lay it out for us a little bit just on what you expect to see next? And then, of course, we have that sentencing in July.
Well, the prosecution will move for whatever sentence they believe is fair. Mr. Trump's lawyers will obviously move for dismissal, but they'll also move for probation. But ultimately, it's going to be up to Judge Merchant, and he's going to make that decision based on the facts and the law, but also on the precedent of other similar cases involving public officials.
You mentioned similar cases, and I can't think of too many similarities, at least when it comes to, you know, the historic nature of this, a former president being convicted of felonies. We've seen the gag order violations and the president coming out again today and speaking out on this case. How do you expect the judge to balance all of that, especially when there's an election coming up?
Well, similar cases, you're right. There are no cases that I can think of with politicians. But Manhattan is full of people who are successful business people who've broken the law and been sentenced. In this case, I do believe that he is going to probably have a hard time putting him in prison. But for the reasons you've cited, I mean, the very large amount of money was involved here. He's got these violations of the gag order. The judge has every right in the world under the law and the facts here to give him prison time. I just don't think that he will do it on the eve of a presidential election where Mr. Trump will be able to make a compelling argument that he needs to be able to be out and ask people for their votes.
Yes, certainly this doesn't happen in a vacuum, and we'll all be watching, of course, as this continues to play out. Thank you so much, Tom Heffelfinger, joining us after following this case, giving us some legal insight. Thank you.
My pleasure.